Slavonia, here we come!
Yay! Okay, we're like 11 minutes away from Dakovo now, and in the very far distance you can see the cathedral in the center of Dakovo. It's just so big, and Slavonia is pretty flat that you can see it from so far away. You guys awake?
Did you have good snooze?
This is a super, super nice place, and we are just getting settled in now. I think we're gonna rest now, have something to eat quickly, and then get a good night's sleep before exploring Dakovo tomorrow. Laku noć, good night.
Good night.
Good night. It's not nighttime.
It's morning.
It's not morning, it's afternoon. So if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up.
Thumbs up.
Don't forget this video. Thumbs up. Thumbs up.
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up.
Say thumbs up.
Thumbs up.
Let me see your thumb.
The next day.
Okay, we are up, out, ready for the day to explore Dakovo. Everyone was up pretty early this morning, so we're getting a good start on the day. We have just the whole day to wander through town and show you all what this sweet little place has to offer. This is such a huge and beautiful cathedral. It just kind of takes your breath away as you're around the corner. This is just such a huge, beautiful square too in front of the cathedral. I think it's one of the biggest squares in Croatia. It's just so wide and open, and of course pedestrian only. Such a beautiful space to hang out, to meet, to walk around. The cathedral has over 7 million bricks. It's so big and just so picturesque. Bishop Strossmayer was one of the most influential Croatians. He was a politician, theologist, writer. This square is named after him, and he was responsible for the construction of this wonderful cathedral. If you can see behind me the towers, they are 84 meters tall, so it's just rising above everything in this area, and that's why you can see the cathedral from almost any point here in Dakovo. It's just dominating over everything. Now we're just walking down the main street here, the street that's lined with a whole bunch of little cafes. It's super cute. The locals here call it Corso. It's just a street for hanging out, relaxing, having coffee, and just enjoying the beautiful atmosphere here. I'm sure we'll be getting ice cream along this street a little later, maybe also some coffee in the afternoon here. It just seems like a great place to do that. It kind of reminds me a little bit of like Tkalčićeva in Zagreb, where people just come, hang out, meet, and catch up.
I have Kontiki.
I have Kontiki also.
No one acting like me.
We all like to sell.
Really, really nice nature park here on the side of the cathedral. Beautiful forested kind of area with pathways around. We're gonna take a little break from the sun, have a little walk around. It's really pretty here, and all the little pathways made of brick, it really makes for a nice stroll. And it feels really good to be in the shade for a few minutes because it is hot and sunny out today.
My leaf, what they pick from the tree.
We are now taking you to one little undiscovered spot. We are gonna go to the wine cellars that are underneath the cathedral.
Takav je kakav je bio i prije, nismo ga ništa ređe.
To znači od početka kad je izgrađena katedrala?
Katedrala je sada tek 140 godina.
Znači on je stariji od katedrale?
Da, stariji osjet od katedrale. Znači ti podrumi su prije katedrale.
It's so cool because the cellars are actually older than the cathedral itself, by about 100 years.
Naša celokupna proizvodnja i prerada vina se odvija u Trnavi. A ovo je u biti samo, evo, kažem, izložbeni dio za turiste i da se vidi onako kako je nekada. Znači, to je prvi pisani zapis u misnim linijima. I onda ima ta četiri grba koja simboliziraju četiri biskupa koja su dali najveći obol u proizvodnji preradi vina, jel? Ovo je prvo biskup Bakić, pa Čolnić, Mandić i Josip Juraj Strossmayer.
So we just got up from the cellar and now we're taking a walk through the gardens here behind the cathedral. This wall here that's behind the cathedral is actually from the 14th century. So it's the oldest wall around here. All right, I think everybody is now getting hungry, so we are gonna make our way to lunch and we are recommended a restaurant. I think it's called Lure. So the kids are sharing a margarita pizza and some chicken and some fries. Surprise, surprise. They don't often have like set kids meals here. So what we do with our three is just order two regular meals and they split it. So just keep that in mind if you're traveling with kids. There aren't often specific kids menus like there are back in North America.
Goulash from like wild boar and venison. Yeah. Very delicious.
And I got some kind of beef pasta. It looks delicious, it smells delicious, so I'm sure it's going to be delicious.
One humongous meal later.
Just to mention again, that whole meal that we got came out to 285 kunas.
The goulash was 42 kunas. My pasta with beef was 62 kunas. The pizza was 33 kunas. Chicken and fries was 25 kunas. And the salads were 24 and 22 kunas.
The value here is really good. Something like this along the coast or even in Zagreb would be a good chunk more expensive.
We like it here because we don't have any money.
So we just finished lunch and now we are gonna go head home to have a little rest. We might just leave it as a free afternoon, but for now it's home and rest time and then continuing on our adventures after that.
The next morning.
Where are we going today, guys?
Going to the horses.
Good morning, everybody. We are on our way to the Dakovo stud farm today to see some beautiful Lipizzaner horses. There are actually two different locations. We are going to visit them both, and we're off to the first one right now.
I hear a squeaky ball.
Yeah. Which town is this?
Dakovo.
Here behind me, they're doing a training, dressage training, which is kind of like dancing for horses. So this is one of their beautiful training arenas inside, and we were lucky enough to come when a training was going on. Okay, so now we're gonna go inside the stables and see the horses inside their little homes. I think they're saying hello to each other.
Look at how beautiful they are. Hi, sweetie. You're pretty. Yes, you are.
Mommy, don't put your camera in it. We're gonna eat it up. Oh, Hoshi, I'm gonna eat your camera.
This stud farm was established in 1506, which makes it one of the oldest stud farms in all of Europe. They actually started breeding the Lipizzaner breed here in the early 19th century. This Lipizzaner breed comes from a place in Slovenia called Lipica. So that's where the breed originally comes from. The horses are so big and beautiful. And here comes a carriage. You guys, here comes a carriage. I think one is done his training now, so maybe he's gonna have a shower and maybe we can watch. We just left the stallion station and now we're driving to Ivandor, which is the second location here where they have, I think, 160 horses. Maybe we'll get to pet some horses. Our kids were really looking forward to petting some horses at the last place and we obviously weren't allowed to, so fingers crossed. Look at these baby ones too, guys. They're big. Okay, so right away we have come across, I don't know, 10 or so horses. And there are even a couple little baby ones, and they're so tiny and cute.
Baby horse, one black baby horse.
It seems like each little baby horse is just kind of glued to its mommy. It's really, really cute.
Maybe it has a baby in her belly. Looks like it's pretty big.
Did you pet the horse?
Yes.
How did he feel?
Soft.
Should we take him home with us?
One day I'm gonna buy myself a horse.
Okay, you can do that, girl. So that's it for our video on Dakovo. I hope you enjoyed it. If you liked it, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. And we hope to see you all again really soon.
That's what horses say.